January 3rd, 1994.
Wow.
So that's 22 years ago.
Oh my God.
So for those of you who are into numerology, 22 is the master number.
Wow. Yeah. Oh my God.
So I know, I was like, January 3rd. And then I did the math, like, 24 is 22 years
ago. Wow.
So that closes auspicious for me. So thank you guys for joining this auspicious circle.
So a little bio on Kathleen Martin and Steve Carnes. So Kathleen's mission was to heal the world one performance at a time. After graduating, Kathleen embarked upon a completely new journey and began pursuing a professional operator. Eventually, offered that Kathleen to be a restoration of the house. He became her full-time voice coach in 2013. The goal of the time was a professional operator for each of them. Both student and teacher had no idea what their partnership would become. Over the course of 18 months, Kathleen and Steve's collaboration has come to center on their shared core mission, which is to love, reach out, care for, serve, and help as many people as it can before they die. Kathleen trusts that everything happens for a reason and believes that every single one of her artistic pursuits is meant to help her love and heal people. She hopes to collaborate with like-minded artists and visionaries to create a new world and eventually transform the entertainment industry. And bravo to you. And Steve Harms, her partner, has been performing national and for over 15 years. He's appeared in 50 productions with Los Angeles Opera and starred in, and I can't even begin to mention, I mean, the list is like, goes on and on, and I think there is a time, and I don't speak Italian, but lots of amazing. There is Rob's in there, Little Shop of Horrors is in there. And so Steve lives by the philosophy that anyone can learn. So it talks about how that he wasn't a singer, he couldn't sing. And so because he overcome that discouragement and proved them incorrect, Steve lives by the philosophy that anyone can learn and do and accomplish anything. This is based largely on his personal experience, having been told that he would never sing and overcoming those obstacles such as vocal nodules, asthma, scoliosis,
wow,
ADHD, and a lisp to become a professional singer. So anyway, without further ado, I'm handing the mics over to Stephen and Pat or Apple.
Oh, you'll hear them.
Oh.
Trust me, you'll hear them.
What's that?
I've seen them perform, you'll hear them.
Yeah, it is okay. When I met them, Christmas Day,
yeah, Christmas Day.
Okay. We met at Shutters, and I had a meeting, and so we went across the way to a beautiful hotel restaurant. We walked into Shutters right when they were finishing up with a spontaneous expression. And so the place is quite quiet, and so we wanted to hear them. And he asked people around, do you mind hearing us? And he started singing, and it was more than amazing. So now we are going to share. So do you want one of these mics?
Oh, everyone who
wants to
know, how can one come over here?
Does it work?
Yeah, no, it's okay. You can do it.
Either that or you
can
not.
Oh. Yeah.
And you've heard that before.
Either one. Acapella. I wanted to say something.
This is a church, so there's resonance in here. They're used to that. There's pitched ceilings.
Firstly, we're incredibly grateful to be here and to be a part of this incredible experience. And we're very happy to be sharing what we believe our gifts are, because we all have our gifts that we are meant to share with each other. No, I guess. No, no. So, what I was going to say is my first reaction coming from a place in my life where I coming from society and limitations that we have and fear, my first response is to think, oh no, I don't want to sing. It's not going to be, it's not going to be perfect. You're obviously going to hear things today because there's junk, right? But overwhelmingly came to me this morning, and because I believe everything happens for a reason, and I went to Stephen, I'm like, that's why I'm sick. To show me that my mission in this world is not only try and help and heal people, but if the more I perform and the more I can be out with people, and if I can start sharing any kind of message, it's sing when you're sick, dance when you're injured.
All day long, so I'm not going to.
What are we going to sing first?
She's going to sing Ave Maria.